Welcome to the Morning Swim Show Streamlined for Friday, October 1st, 2010, brought to you by swimoutlet.com, the web's most popular swim shop. Laure Manaudou is coming back to competitive swimming. Taking a page from Dara Torres and Amanda Beard, the 2004 Olympic champ has been in the pool in Marseille, France, with the mindset of competing at the 2012 Olympics. Manaudou gave birth to a baby girl in April and retired from the sport in September 2009. In a couple of weeks, she'll be heading to Auburn University with her partner Fred Bousquet to train with Brett Hawke. A FINA rule, however, could keep Manaudou out of the World Championships next year. FINA clearly states that an athlete must notify FINA of their intentions to return to the sport at least 9 months before their first competition. If the announcement on the French Swimming Federation site yesterday is Manaudou's official notification, then she's going to fall 3 months shy of being able to swim in the French Nationals next March. That meet will be the qualifier for the French team going to the World Championships. Manaudou will have some work ahead of her if she plans to swim the 400 free. She'll face a slew of challengers that have arisen since she won Olympic gold in 2004, including world record holder Federica Pellegrini. Break out your college apparel. This weekend marks the official start of the 2010-2011 college swimming and diving season. Just about every team begins competition this weekend with dual meet or invitational contests. Florida, the reigning women's Division I champs, will host the All-Florida invite with freshman Elizabeth Beisel set to swim in her first collegiate competition. Stanford, the women's runner-up last March, hosts San Jose State today in Palo Alto. And with the loss of Julia Smith to graduation, the Cardinal will rely on seniors Kate Dwelly and Kelsey Ditto, as well as freshman Felicia Lee. On the men's side, Texas doesn't officially start their campaign to repeat as NCAA champions until later this month, but they'll do some racing today at their inter-squad meet in Austin. The Cal Berkeley Golden Bears, second last year to Texas, participated in an exhibition meet last week with Cal Poly, with NCAA champions Tom Shields posting a 48.2 in the 100 fly and Demir Duganyuk swimming a 55.5 in the 100 breast. We'll have plenty of results on our college channel at swimmingworld.com. The opening ceremony of the Commonwealth Games takes place Sunday, with most sports like swimming getting underway on Monday. With the major time difference, the first prelim session for swimming will start at 11 p.m. Eastern Time on Sunday, with the first race and finals on the blocks at 6:30 a.m. Eastern Monday. We'll be covering the meet on swimmingworld.com with up-to-the-minute results throughout the week. And be sure to check out our Poll of the Week segment today to find out who visitors to our website thought would be the breakout star of the Commonwealth Games. And finally today, the Beijing Water Cube, where Michael Phelps won 8 gold medals, Jason Lezak became a superhero, Dara Torres proved age is just a number, and Matthew Mitchum broke China's diving winning streak, is now a water park. This footage from CNN shows the recent opening day of the water park in the same place where swimmers and divers once achieved athletic glory. The Water Cube is now the first Olympic pool in at least 50 years to be completely renovated to the point that the original competition pool no longer exists. Just for reference, the 1960 Olympic pool in Rome was used for last year's World Championships, and pretty much every Olympic pool since then remains as public pools except for the 1984 and 1996 pools, which belong now to university. The Water Cube was given the makeover because officials believe it would make more money as an entertainment venue than a conventional swimming pool, and it looks like they're packing them in, at least for now. That's the news for today. We'll enjoy the weekend, and we'll see you next time on swimmingworld.tv.